Hello everyone, welcome to this GoSkills.com video. My name's Francesco, and what we're going to do in this video is cover the new Microsoft To-Do. Now, for those who don't know, Microsoft To-Do was recently introduced by Microsoft as a replacement to Wunderlist. Now, Wunderlist was a very successful task management application with over 10 million users. And now they've moved to this new experience, which many people aren't debating to be a good replacement to Wunderlist. So we're going to jump into some of the features, share some of the best ways that you can use it, and explore whether this is a viable to-do list application for you. So as you can see, I'm on my Microsoft To-Do account. It's very simple. As you can see, you've got this pinned My Day tab at the top. Now, My Day is essentially adding tasks that you will complete in your day. So this could be create full Microsoft To-Do review. And I add that by simply pressing enter, and it will automatically add to my day. As you can see, one appears there, so I can actually see that it will also go into the to-do inbox, which I have inside of the one down from there. So as you can see, you can double click into a to-do, make sure it's added to there, or you can remove it either way, which is something that that just pulls it outside of that. So if I want to add that again, I click add to my day and it will bring it back to my day. You can add a reminder to a specific time or even just later today, tomorrow or next week. You can add a due date to it. Due date's slightly different. It's when it's actually due to be complete. And you can add any new notes to it. Once you go over to my day and you want to complete this, you just tick it and it will strike it through, which is a very easy thing to do. Now, as you can see down the bottom, you've got the ability to add new lists. So for example, if I wanted to add a new list called movies to watch, and then what happens is that is created down in the lists. You can edit this, you can change the theme, you can adapt what scene. So I maybe want blue with a mountain in the background, which is quite a nice design. You can also have these emojis put at the start. So for example, if I wanted to add an emoji to the start of that, what will happen is it will be used as a sort of like a pinned icon. You can move these up and around, which is good. And obviously you can naturally start adding items to there. And as you can imagine, it's very easy to sort them based on alphabetically due date, creation date, completed and added to my day. Now, of course, you can hide completed to-dos as well and rename the list at any time. You can also adapt the theme as well to make sure it fits to what you have. So as you can see, it's a very simple way to start adding to-dos. There are a couple of things that you need to note. There are no subtasks here, so you can't actually add any subtasks below a certain task, which sort of is a bit annoying. However, this is in preview mode, so Microsoft are continually developing it. It has some promise to it. However, at the moment, it's not a strong application for to-do list. However, if you're looking for a super basic one, then this might be your catch. If you haven't checked out GoSkills.com, there is great content, courses, and also sessions over on GoSkills.com where you can learn about anything new and apply it to all of your businesses or your activities or even your work that you're doing at the moment. So there's lots to learn and lots to go deep into on GoSkills.com. Anyway, guys, make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very soon.